unnecessary ultrasounds and to torment our friends and family just a little. We didn't find out whether we're having a boy or girl this pregnancy. It won't be long now until the big reveal, so I decided to search out the old wives' tales of the internet for baby gender prediction. 11 fun tricks to find out gender of baby. 1. Carrying high or low. This one says that you carry lower with a boy and higher with a girl. Both of my babies have been very low. He was engaged early even though he didn't show up until 42 weeks, 2 days. 2. Heart rate. Supposedly the heart rate will be faster for girls than boys. He's heart rate is always right around 150. Baby number 2 has been between 130 and 150 so far. 3. Craving sweet or sour. Of course, if you're craving sweet you might be having a girl, but if all you want is sour it's a boy. Early in my pregnancy, I was craving pumpkin, baked potatoes, almond chicken, and popcorn. Lately, it's been the stereotypical pickles. Since I gave up sweets in January, and I cannot even have much fruit due to my blood sugar issues, my cravings for sweet are pretty much non-existent by now. 4. Chinese calendar. This is the method for baby gender prediction that my first midwife says is often very accurate. It uses the mother's age and month of conception to calculate whether you will have a boy or girl. It was right for baby number 1. This time around it says we're having a boy. We'll see if it can go 2 for 2. It was right for baby number 1. This time around it says we're having a boy. We'll see if it can go 2 for 2. 5. Mayan gender prediction. Similar to the Chinese calendar, the Mayan version uses the mother's age and year of conception to predict gender. If both are even or odd, then it's a girl. If one is even and the other is odd, then it's a boy. That would mean we're having a boy. 6. Pregnancy complexion. In theory, moms of girls experience more breakouts during pregnancy. I haven't had much of any this pregnancy except very early on. 7. Morning sickness. If you're super sick during the first trimester, that indicates a girl. Just a little queasy? It might be a boy. I wasn't sick for very long this time. However, I never threw up with my first, and I did this time, a couple of times. Still, I know it wasn't bad compared to what a lot of people have. Sleeping on your left side you might be having a boy. Sleeping on your right indicates a girl. I lay down every night on my right side even though I know the left side is better for positioning the baby. It just seems more comfortable. 9. Soft or dry hands. Little girls are all softness and sweetness from the start. If you have soft hands during pregnancy, it means a girl, and dry hands suggest a boy. Since we hand wash all our dishes, they've been a bit dry. 10. Graceful vs clumsy. Although I've heard that pregnancy makes everyone a little clumsy, this one says that a graceful mama will have a girl, and a clumsy one will have a boy. I have definitely taken my share of dramatic trips and falls in both pregnancies. 11. Moody mama. If you're moody during pregnancy, it means a girl. Aside from a couple of major meltdowns in the first trimester of my first pregnancy, I was pretty stable. This time, I'm sure everyone around me can attest that I've been moodier. I've also noticed I cry more easily than the sappy little things. One of my midwives mentioned that I could be having such an all-around different pregnancy because I'm reacting to the hormones of a different gender baby. Maybe there's something to it.